Hello friends, welcome to eKeeda. Now we'll see the effect on the performance of transmission line due to inductance. We already studied in our last video effect due to resistance. That at higher frequency, current density in the conductor is non-uniform. Current density in the conductor is non-uniform. It is more at the surface of the conductor and less at the center of the conductor, where delta is the current density. And resistance of AC circuit depends upon length, resistivity, area of cross section, frequency, which is known as skin effect, and spiraling. What is spiraling? Means we increase the length, and when length is increased, resistance also increase. Means spiraling means conductor is wounded in order to increase the mechanical strength. Main aim is to increase the mechanical strength by wounding the conductor, which is known as spiraling. Now, current carrying wire always produce magnetic field, means inductor. And current carrying wire always produce electric field, means capacitive behavior. This can be line to line or line to ground. Potential difference means capacitive behavior. We know C is equals to QV, where Q is the charge and V is the potential difference. Now we'll see the effect due to inductance. See, I already told you that current carrying wire always produce magnetic field, means inductor. So inductance of a circuit is defined as the flux linkage per unit current. Now, inductance, I already told you that transmission line is a distributed network. Value of RLC depends on length, and unit is defined as per unit length. So current carrying wire always produce magnetic field. So obviously flux link acts at, So current carrying wire always produce magnetic field. I already told you that current carrying wire always produce magnetic field, means inductor. So obviously flux link at some point and inductance come. So inductance of a circuit is defined as flux linkage per unit current. Therefore, in order to find the inductance of a circuit, determination of a flux linkage is necessary. Two important cases of flux linkages are: first, flux linkage due to internal flux, and second, flux linkage due to external flux. So inductance calculation on first point, flux linkage due to internal flux. So first see the calculation of inductance. First point, first case, flux linkage due to internal flux. So this is flux linkage due to internal flux. Consider a long straight cylindrical conductor of radius R and carrying a current I. This current will set up a magnetic field, and the magnetic lines of force will exit inside the conductor as well as outside the conductor. So both these fluxes will contribute to the inductance of the conductor. First, we'll see the flux linkage due to internal flux. This is a conductor. First, understand that for calculation of inductance, you need to calculate or you need to know flux linkages. And for flux linkages, you need to know flux density. And for flux density, you need to know magnetic field intensity. Remember this. So consider this. See in this diagram, this is a conductor. So consider this distance to be R. R. This is a straight cylindrical conductor of radius R and carrying a current I. So this distance R, and at this distance X, draw a circle with radius X. Draw a circle with radius X. Cut, edit. So at a distance X, draw a circle with radius X. This circle with radius X. This is what I am interested in. So consider another small element dx. This dx and small length dl. This small length dl. So at this small differential length, calculate magnetic field intensity hx. As you know, integral, close integral of hx dl is equals to ix. You know this. So integrate, this is equals to hx dl 2 pi x, this is equals to ix, and hx is equals to ix upon 2 pi x. We get hx. Now consider this whole conductor. There is current passing in it. So there is a current passing in it. And consider this small part of radius x, and of radius r. Even that part carries a current, and current carried in this part and whole conductor is different. Means current Ix is different from entire current in conductor, means I. As we know that current flow is directly proportional to the cross-sectional area. So Ix by I is equals to pi x square upon pi r square. Pi cancel, pi r square for current I. So Ix is equals to x square upon r square into I. Substitute this Ix in this Hx. Suppose this is equation 1 and this is equation 2. So substitute equation 2 in equation number 1. Substitute Ix in Hx. So we get Hx is equals to Ix upon 2 pi x. So this is equals to x square upon r square I upon 2 pi x. This x cancel out. So this is Hx is equals to x I upon 2 pi r square ampere turn per meter. Suppose this is equation 3. So we need to further calculate magnetic field density Bx. We know Bx is equals to mu of Hx, where mu is equals to mu naught into mu r. So write Bx is equals to nu and hx is equals to x into I upon 2 pi r square, Weber per meter square. Put the value of nu. So bx is equals to nu into xi upon 2 pi r square Weber per meter square. And we know nu is equals to nu naught into nu r. So put the value of nu. But for non-magnetic material, nu r is equals to 1. So put bx is equals to nu naught xi upon 2 pi r square Weber per meter square. Now flux linkages. See, we are considering a small tubular element. This small tubular element we are considering, we have a radius x. This radius x and a small tubular element dx. This small tubular element dx. If I want flux per meter length, flux per meter length, so d phi is equal to bx into 1 into dx. This d phi is the flux through a cylindrical shell of radius thickness dx and axial length 1 meter, which is given by d phi is equal to bx into 1 into dx. Now put the value of bx, d phi is equals to bx is equals to nu naught x into I upon 2 pi r square into dx, Weber per meter. We know that flux linkage which we want means flux length is at x. So 0 is greater than x is greater than r. See, total current I, this flux links with just a part of I, and that part of current is pi x square upon pi r square. So flux linkage for d phi, flux linkage for d phi per meter length flux linkage d psi is equals to pi x square upon pi r square into d phi. So we know d phi is equals to nu naught xi upon 2 pi r square. Put the value of d phi, x square upon r square into nu naught xi upon 2 pi r square into dx. Now this d psi is equals to nu naught I x cube upon 2 pi r 4 into dx, Weber turn per meter. This is flux linkage. Radius starts with 0 and end with r. This radius starts with 0 and end with r. So total flux linkage from center up to conductor surface is equals to total flux linkage from center 0 up to conductor surface r is equals to psi internal is equals to 0 to r d psi. Now put the value of d psi, 0 to r d psi is equals to nu naught I x cube upon 2 pi r 4 into dx. Now put the limit, this is equals to nu naught I upon 2 pi r 4, and this is x cube, we can write this as r 4 upon 4. So this r 4 cancel out. So psi internal is equals to nu naught I upon 2 4 is 8 pi Weber turns per meter length. This is total flux linkage, internal flux linkage. And we know nu naught is equals to 4 pi into 10 to the power minus 7 Henry per meter. So this nu internal is, So this psi internal is equals to 0.5 I into 10 to the power minus 7 Weber turn per meter. And this inductance internal is equals to psi internal upon I. If you have to calculate internal inductance, this is equals to psi internal upon total current. So now let us calculate the flux linkage of the conductor due to external flux, this second case. So flux linkage due to external flux, the external flux extends from the surface of the conductor. Suppose this is conductor. And suppose there are two points. Point one, cut, edit. And suppose there are two points which are carrying flux. So this is point one at a distance d1. And distance from point two, d2. This is d2. Now taken at a distance x. Tubular element dx. This tubular element dx. We know that hx is equals to I upon 2 pi x. Ampere turn per meter. We already find this in internal flux. This hx is equals to I upon 2 pi x. And bx is equals to nu naught I upon 2 pi x Weber per meter square. See, dx is the tubular element and d phi is the flux in that tubular element, thickness dx. So d phi is equals to bx into dx. So this is equals to nu naught I upon 2 pi x into dx Weber per meter. See the flux d phi, this flux d phi links all the current in the conductor once and only once. So total current I. Therefore, flux linkages d psi is equals to d phi. So this is equals to nu naught I upon 2 pi x dx Weber turns per meter. Now total flux linkage of the conductor from this total flux linkage of the conductor from point 1 to point 2 means from distance 1 to distance 2 is equals to total flux linkage of the conductor is equals to this d psi is equals to from distance 1 to distance 2 nu I upon 2 pi x into dx. So this is equals to nu naught I from point 1 to point 2 upon 2 pi and x, we can write this as log d2 by d1. So this is the total flux linkage of the conductor from point 1 to point 2. Now we know nu naught is equals to 4 into 10 to the power minus 7 Henry per meter. And we know the value for nu naught. Nu naught is equals to 4 into 10 to the power minus 7 Henry per meter. So overall flux linkage, psi is equals to psi internal plus psi external. So this is equals to nu naught I upon 8 pi psi internal is equals to this nu naught I upon 8 pi plus this, sorry, this is psi external. So psi external is equals to means for psi 1.2 psi external is equals to d1 to d2 nu naught I upon 2 pi x dx. Nu naught I upon 2 pi x into dx. So we can write this as psi is equals to take nu naught I upon 2 pi common. So this is equals to 1 by 4 plus d1 to d2 dx upon x Weber turns per meter. Weber turns per meter length. This is overall flux linkage. Thank you.